which one is to select for your application, you can visit contentofcpr.com or refer to the one way selection tools elsewhere on their website and in our marketing literature. A very simple phenomenon, because basically what we did is we took this particular plasmid that has this mini gene, and then we cut it right in the middle of that 2 amino acid mini gene. The cut of the blood and cloning isn't getting fragments in, it's keeping the vector that doesn't have an insert from closing up without an insert, and that's what has to be reduced. But in this way, with the toxic mini gene that's been cut right in the middle where the researcher puts their insert, if it does this and closes it up, it's a laser event for the cell, and so you never get a cloning outbreak. So what we have developed for our customer is a method where they can clone into this inactive mini gene, and the only events that will lead to cell growth, which leads to a colony outbreak, are going to be the ones that have an insert interrupting it, because this is fatal, this with an insert in the middle is not. So it just makes it easier that when they get this data, they look at it and they see colonies, that they see what they want. I'm going to actually talk about how the PCR clones was developed. And looking back on it, this really had a couple of phases. And the first phase was way back in graduate school. One of the things that helped me choose my major in graduate school was going to a lecture about bacteriophages. And the very first time I saw a picture of T4 DNA, so it's random on a cell, and just taking over that entire cell's history. It was just so amazing to me that something that was so incredibly small could wreak such havoc so quickly and successfully. So I've always been fascinated with little things that have huge effects on their virus. Fast forward to about 10, 11 years ago, I wrote this article in PNAS that talked about mini genes, which I had never heard of. But it turns out that mini genes are mini genes that have less than 5 amino acids that they code for. And yet, a lot of them can't handle them well. And so mini genes create terrible problems themselves when they're trying to be expressed. And the way to think about it is that the ribosome has evolved to handle certain genes. But something that small is kind of out of its specs. It doesn't quite know what to do. And so, even on the idea that something so small, a simple 2 to 5 amino acid mini gene could just kill a cell, was something that seemed so strange and incredible to me. So, back at the beginning of the PCR cloning kit, I could pull that from the back of my mind and say, is this something that we can use? Because it's such a clever phenomenon. Is it something that we can do in the biotech community?